this bike came back to market, I tell you what, I'd really seriously like to get one. Nope, it's not a KTM 690 Enduro R, but I'll tell you what, it would be KTM's biggest competitor. We're going to get into it. We're going to talk about it on the Rant and Ride.
Look what happened. I woke up in a big old tub of money.
Hey, all you KTM guys, come on, I'm Team Warren. Don't think I'm coming down on you. I, on the other hand, and you, on the other hand, and a lot of people, on the other hand. So why don't we have a 450? A lot of ice.
But here's my thinking.
Hey guys, Joe here, 690 ADV, 690 Garage, 690ADV.com. What's happening? Hope everybody had a fantastic week. As usual, it's 50-50. It's never always perfect, but it's not a horrible week. It did start off pretty not much fun, and then it gradually started getting better. Why? Because it's Friday. Anyway, I appreciate you guys stopping in, watching the Rant and Ride, especially this week's. This week's really kind of a cool topic, and I'm really hoping I can get a lot out of you guys in the comments on the info, because I'm really wanting the info on this. On this video, because I think it's a good one and it's something that I kind of wish and hope comes back around. Don't forget, go to the website, sign up, 690adv.com, go down to the bottom part and sign up, get in so that you can win on the decals. Don't forget, you got to be signed up. You don't have to be a subscriber. I want you as a subscriber, but you don't have to be a subscriber to win and be part of the 690 channel. You don't even have to own a motorcycle if you don't want to. But hopefully by watching the channel and listening to all the great subscribers and commenters, guys that are out there, that we can get you into this wonderful, wonderful motorcycle sport, because it's awesome. I think it'll change your life and it'll make you super, super happy. And it'll bring something into your life that you don't have, which is a fantastic adventure happiness. Anyway, on to the rant. Let's talk about the bike that could theoretically, if it were to come back, put a cramping in the style of the KTM Enduro, especially the 690. And I don't really want to talk about so much the 701, because the 701, it's a kind of a 690 ripoff. Now, I know you Husqvarna guys, you're going to say, oh, it's not, it's a totally different bike. Well, it is, but it's really kind of not. It was really a direct competition to the 690, and KTM bought them. So I don't really want to make this about that, because this bike actually did. And a lot of guys own these bikes, and they will tell you that they're better than the 690. They'll tell you it's better than a 690. I don't know if I say it's better, but I'll tell you what, man, it is definitely a massive, huge competitor. And if they brought it back, could be a insane competitor. Honda's XR650R. That's right. All you Honda guys, 650R. What if they brought that bike back? What if they brought it back? What would it do? What would that bike do to the market for the 690? Because the Honda 650R, guess what? 2000 to 2007, 2008, they're gone. They were gone. Why? Why, Honda? Why did you get rid of it? Why could you not build on that platform, man? Are you kidding me? An aluminum frame. That Honda XR650R was a beast, a beast. And people are like, well, the 650L, it's really close. No, they look close, but they are completely different bikes. And I know you Honda guys out there, and I've got a bunch of you guys talk about it, because I know there's guys out there that have an XR650R in their stable, and I want to know more about that horse. I've seen them, I've heard them. My neighbor's got one. It's an old one. It's a chop bike. Looks like something out of Mad Max. And that thing will flat just power wheelie like this 690 in third gear. It is sick, insane, and it's carburetor driven. Carburetor driven. Five speed. It's got 61 horsepower on that bike. Right out of the gate. It is a beast. It's 37-inch seat height. Basically, the whole build out of that bike, it's almost like the KTM 690 Enduro R. Almost the same. It's got 12 inches of ground clearance. So if you don't know much about the Honda XR650R and you're trying to get the information here from it, if you don't know, go look it up. It was the Baja 1000 King. The Baja 1000 King. It is an amazing, amazing motorcycle. It probably won more Baja 1000s through its span than any other motorcycle in that period. Just a fantastic bike. 2.6 gallons of gas, so it doesn't have a ton of gas, but you know what? They make tons of aftermarkets for that thing. You can put on those big safari tanks and all that stuff and really deck that bike out. And though they're not street legal, guys convert them. You see them out there, and it is such a magnificent bike, and it has so much power, and it has so much Honda awesomity in that bike. Why did Honda stop making that bike? I do not understand. Now, hear me out. Now that we know the rough roundabout specs, if you don't know about it, and all you Honda guys out there, down below, comment, tell me about it, tell everybody else about that Honda XR650R, about it. Tell everybody why it is the beast that it is. Tell them why it's the beast. And what'd you do to that bike? What did you do? Because I know there's tons of mods for that bike that you can make that thing just basically just flat. It make it crazy. You can make it a crazy, crazy bike, especially a dual sport enduro bike. So down there below, let everybody know about it. But here's my thinking. What if? Now they discontinued the Africa Twin, which everybody knows. Everybody knows Africa Twin, but it's amazing. The Africa Twin's back. They made it better. Now you'll get old school Honda guys go, no, they didn't. They just brought it back, blah, 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 blah. But in all reality, they really did kind of make it better. You know, they put some extra stuff on it. They made it lighter, you know, gave it more power. But this isn't about the Africa Twin. This is about that Honda XR650R. Here's my thinking. What if Honda secretly is in the back right now building a 650R that is street legal? It's basically put the 450, that new one that came out that I don't get that. I've seen it. I went to the show. Don't want to talk about it. But the blinkers they put, I like them. They're full flexi. You can't break them off. Very cool. Honda got that right. Super, super nice. Put those on the front and the back. LEDs, so they're nice and bright. And they're not very big. So they do that. And then let's bump it up to a 6-speed. Put it in a 6-speed. Or you old Honda guys that may own one or know a lot about them, what do you think? Do you think it needs a 6-speed? I think it needs a 6-speed, just only because of the highway. That one extra gear will help that bike smooth out on the highway a little bit, you know, that basically cruising gear. But what do you think? Would a 6-speed be great? Because I think a 6-speed would be really, really nice. Take that carburetor out, go fuel injected, fly-by-wire. Put that fly-by-wire, like the KTM. Fly-by-wire, get that good response. I mean, when you hit it, it'll go. Give it fuel injected. That way it will meet the emissions. Because carburetor, we all know carburetors, I hate to say it, if it's not a dirt bike, it's going away. The carburetor-driven street bikes are just not going to be around much longer. They're slowly phasing them out. That's why the KLR is dying. But do go to the fuel injected. I'm thinking fly-by-wire. What do you think about that? Maybe go with the fold-away mirrors. Keep it nice, keep it light, keep it tight, make that baby rock all night is what I'm thinking. But that's what I'm thinking it needs. If you think it needs something that I missed, what do you think? Because it's got a 2118 tire, so it's got the right tire setup. That you don't have to change, but it is carburetor. So I think fuel injected. Maybe bring it up with some blinkers and supplies. Oh, yeah, maybe the number one thing, get rid of that freaking kickstart, man. A 650 kickstart is just, it's insane, man. Nobody wants to do that. give it an electric start, and still keep the kicker like Honda does for the WRs. Very cool, man. Just in case you leave something on and you don't get yourself stranded like some people out there if it's just strictly an electric start. Keep the kicker on there just in case you want to, but give it the electric start. I think that would be fantastic. So Honda XR650R, what a magnificent bike. It's such a shame that they took it away from us. You can still find them, but maybe bring it back. I think it would be a huge competitor in that mid-range market, and it's in the right weight range. And at 380 pounds dry, 317, it's right at the same weight as the KTM 690 Enduro R. That Honda XR650R, it's got a place. Come on, Honda. Come on, Honda. Give it back to us. Give it back to us. I'd buy one. I'm telling you right now, I would go buy one. Oh, speaking of buy one, notice I'm not wearing the KTM jacket. I tell you what, this is going to be a coming up video. You will not believe the price of this jacket. And I tell you what, it's pretty chilly right now. I am very, very comfortable. And it's a very comfortable jacket. Going to have a full write-up review on it. And it's pretty cool for all you people looking for a basic budget jacket that's cool and looks nice. Don't want to get too much into it, but just check around. It's going to be coming up soon. But anyway, like I said, XR from Honda, the 650R XR. Are you kidding me? What a fantastic bike. Just a shame they took it from us. So I personally think that the KTM 690 Enduro R, if we got a new Honda XR 650R, it would be a direct competition and it would definitely cut in to KTM's bread and butter with their Enduro bikes. I really, really don't do. I really honestly believe that that would happen. And I think you would basically see a lot of people getting on board buying that bike. What do you think? Tell me about it. Put it down in the comments. And all you XR guys or Honda guys that are out there, even KTM guys, tell me if you think I'm crazy. Put it down there. Tell me the positives and the negatives between the two and if you think that it would actually go head-to-head with KTM and their cells. Because KTM, as we all know, they're pretty much the king. They're pretty much the king. So. But let me know. And anyway, I appreciate your time. You guys have a magnificent and fantastic Friday. Be safe out there. Find your adventure. Get on your bike. Ride. And I tell you what, just be happy, man. Because today could be the last day for the rest of your life. But anyway, at 690, we love you. I appreciate your time. You guys have a great weekend. 690 out.